Hello everyone, welcome to Smart Coach. The first current affair that we have today is India had evidenced most deaths caused by pollution in the year 2017. Now this current affair is a part of environment, which is a part of your GS paper 3. In 2017, pollution was found responsible for 15% of all the deaths held globally. According to a report, about 2.3 million people in India died due to pollution. This report was published by the Global Alliance on Health and Pollution, GAHP, and the report is named the 2019 Pollution and Health Metrics Global, Regional and Country Analysis. The findings for the report was from the Lancet Commission on Pollution and Health. According to the report, it includes three lists of pollution-induced deaths, wherein India is the only country that features in the top 10 in all the three lists. Up next, we have a current affair from the Defence and Security Forum. It is about Pinaka, the guided rocket system. Pinaka guided rocket system, developed indigenously, was successfully test-fired from a base in Odisha coast on 19th December 2019 in a boost to the Army's artillery power. Next, let us have a look into the insights of this Pinaka guided rocket system. Pinaka is a multi-barrel rocket launch system used by the Indian Army, and it is developed by the DRDO. Pinaka, as reported, integrates the state-of-art technology for delivering superior combat performance. Up next, we have the current affairs from international relations. India and USA have concluded several agreements in both defense and civilian sectors at the 2+2 ministerial dialogue held in Washington, D.C. Next, let us look into the highlights of this dialogue. First, the Industrial Security Annex. So, the Industrial Security Annex to the India-US General Security of Military Information Agreement will provide a framework for the exchange and protection of classified military information between the two countries. United States has announced its commitment to being the founding member of CDRI, whose headquarters will be located in India. The CDRI, that is the Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure, is actually an initiative of Prime Minister Modi, which was launched in September 2019. Next, the proposed industry-to-industry framework under DTTI will establish a standing mechanism for the dialogue and exchanges between US and the Indian defense companies and their governments on defense technologies and the industrial cooperation. After that, a memorandum was signed by the Indian Ministry of Jal Shakti and the US Geological Survey to actually promote the technical cooperation in the water resource management and the water technology. The new science and technology agreement was concluded, and it is actually an amendment that was made to the 2005 agreement, which provides a framework for the collaboration between the two countries in all the fields of science, technology and innovation. After that, both the sides have even agreed to cooperate for the exchange of information in space situational awareness, including space debris and space traffic management. The US Federal Judicial Center, as well as the India's National Judicial Academy, is seeking to expand their mutual beneficial cooperation in the areas of counter-terrorism jurisprudence to new areas of criminal jurisprudence, including instances of money laundering, drug trafficking, etc. Prime Minister Modi at the East Asia Summit has appreciated the India's Indo-Pacific Ocean Initiative and has expressed interest in further expanding the cooperation on ocean issues through bilateral India-US Ocean Dialogue. The IP Ocean Initiative aims to create a safe, secure and stable maritime domain calls for collaborative efforts to safeguard the oceans, including the plastic litter, build capacity and fairly share resources, reduce disaster risk, enhance science and technology, academic cooperation, and even promote free, fair and mutually beneficial trade and maritime support. It has also been promised to hold the India-US joint tri-services and the amphibious exercise, the Tiger Triumph, on an annual basis, which was first held in November 2019 as a humanitarian assistance and disaster relief exercise to develop the synergies between the tri-services of both the countries, including the HADR operation. Next, the two sides have even agreed to facilitate a proposed memorandum of agreement between the Ministry of Civil Aviation as well as the US Federal Aviation Administration. This MOA will provide the technical assistance to the Ministry of Civil Aviation in developing, modernizing, operating as well as maintaining the civil aviation infrastructure in India. Next, let us move into science and technology. So, the Pune Construction Engineering Research Foundation claims to develop India's first indigenous concrete maturity meter, which can determine the strength of concrete used in construction. This research foundation is actually a non-profit organization which works to introduce new and cost-effective technologies in the sector. The device that they have produced can help significantly in reducing the margin of error in estimating the strength of a structure while cutting project cost as well. Now, this device have also been dubbed as the Intelligent Concrete Maturity Meter as it is very affordable and very easy to use. It is also said that it will be available at 30-40% of the cost of the foreign maturity meter that is still in use in the market. The last current affair that we have today is from economics. So, the Reserve Bank of India is going to conduct an operational twist on December 23rd to manage its yield. The Reserve Bank of India has decided to conduct a simultaneous purchase and sale of government securities worth 10,000 crore on 23rd of December under its open market operation, which is aimed at managing the yields. To know more about open market operation, click on the link in the description below. So viewers, that was all about the current affairs for today. For more such current affair videos, stay tuned to Smart Coach. For the detailed article, click on the link given in the description below.